The Chesapeake Bay watershed covers over 64,000 square miles and was once largely covered with forest. Today, millions of people call the watershed home.
How the land changes impacts ecosystems, impacts the Chesapeake Bay. So where we have more development, we have more runoff. That can lead to more pollution into the waterways if it's not controlled. So it's important to keep track of changes in pollutant sources, land use being one of them.
Peter Claggett is with the U.S. Geological Survey and works at the Chesapeake Bay Program Office.
Land use changes how the landscape changes over time in a way that humans use the land. This is Talbot County on the eastern shore of Maryland. So we can look at an area here, and this is forest in green, and this is formerly agriculture in orange. This is 2013 land use, land cover data. And then we can look at change over time, and you can see how this area is developing new commercial establishments. And then we can look at the imagery beneath it to see like exactly the type of change that depicts.
The Chesapeake Bay's land use data is free for use by the public. Local governments and organizations can use the data to set conservation goals and to target areas where restoration can make the most impact. The Eastern Shore Land Conservancy monitors and maintains more than 50,000 acres in Maryland. Michael Ports is their easement stewardship manager.
Today we're actually right outside of the town of Easton in Talbot County. We're monitoring an easement that's a little over 100 acres of mostly farm, but it's got a few natural areas and forests tucked away as well. It's providing a water quality buffer for Peach Blossom Creek, which of course inevitably goes into the Chesapeake Bay. But it's also acting like another buffer. It's buffering development from the town of Easton, and it's helped keeping those areas concise and economically viable while keeping these areas beautiful and well-maintained and still part of the core culture of this area, which is agriculture.
Pete Lesher lives on Maryland's eastern shore and is the vice president of the Talbot County Council.
Frankly, so many of us love living here that we're sort of loving this place to death. Well, the good news is that land use is changing only incrementally, but that incremental change is always away from farmland and toward development. And so we have to be extra careful the more people who are here and take more measures to make sure that that this will be here for the next generation.
A conservation easement limits certain types of land use in perpetuity for conservation purposes.
Today I met up with Cait, my colleague from Eastern Shore Land Conservancy. This farm that we've been looking at is one of those that is under a new conservation easement.
Yeah, as part of our monitoring for checking the easements, we're also looking into the woods and checking on the health of the trees and presence of wildlife.
Forested buffers are a great way to improve that water quality between the field and the waterway. I hope in the future that we will find more funding to be able to set aside more of this land so that it will remain in the same character that it is today.
The Chesapeake Bay landscape is changing a lot. We have many urban centers in the Chesapeake Bay, and all around the periphery of these urban areas is where we see the most change, which is associated with urban development.
Loudoun County, Virginia is home to over 400,000 people. That's more than 800 people per square mile.
Northern Virginia is developing at a very fast pace. Loudoun County is one of the fastest growing counties, not just in Virginia, but in the country. I think what really guides Leesburg and Loudoun County on their land use planning is balance. They're trying to balance both the natural and the urban environment.
We're in the town of Leesburg, and we're at the conjunction of Tuscarora Creek and Downtown Branch. Both of them have experienced a lot of development upstream, especially Town Branch, and as a result, a lot of runoff. There was extensive flooding in this area. The Loudoun Wildlife Conservancy, the Piedmont Environmental Council, and several other like-minded organizations decided this would be an ideal place to do a riparian buffer planting. It mitigates flooding and erosion significantly.
This buffer complements the downstream restoration project by the town of Leesburg that has mitigated flooding issues for nearby residents. Residents in the adjacent neighborhood benefit from reduced flooding and insurance costs.
They adjusted the flood zone so that it actually comes more out into the park and into that newly created riparian zone rather than into people's yards and into their basements. Where you want to be is in a place where you can have that high density, you can have that apartment complex, but you have green infrastructure around it. So it's a desirable place to live. You mitigate the heat island effect, you help with the water quality, and you create an environment that's really attractive. Sound planning creates livable, high-quality communities for people to live in.